stress. And so people are stressed and they're anxious. And it seems as if all the chatter and anger on television doesn't match up to their lives. And it breaks our civic trust and it makes people feel the game is rigged and nobody's looking out for them. And historically, in most kind of conditions, that's right for opportunists to try to exploit America's history and religion, racial, ethnic, religious. And politicians try to keep us angry, keep us sick. And they appeal to our tribal instincts, and appeal to fear. And they try to pit one group against the other. And they tell us, oh, order and security will be restored if it weren't for those folks who don't look like us and sound like us. Or pray like we do. That is an old playbook. It is old as time. And the closer you get to election day, you can count on more and more politicians trying to pull out that playbook. Now, here's the thing. In a healthy democracy, that playbook doesn't work. In a healthy democracy, where everybody's participating and paying attention and listening, voting. People are pretty willing in both parties. They call out the bigots and the fear mongers. And then they work to compromise, they work to get things done. Black voters, they have to in our minds. And we don't vote when we take our basic rights for granted. Other voices fill the board. And demagogues get out there and they promise simple fixes to complicated problems. I mean, I know that sometimes. You know, when I was president, even when I was candidate, folks would say, Barack, you're talking too long. No, they're too professorial, they're explaining stuff too much. I know that. But sometimes things are complicated. And I was confident that the American people wanted to hear the truth.
NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.